Hey guys, and welcome to Devil's Fork. I'm Chef Sergio Taddeo, and today we are making a delicious, authentic pasta fagioli, just like your grandmother used to make. It's gonna be amazing. Let's get it! Alright guys, so today we're making a delicious pasta fagiolo autenticamente italiana! Meats, guys, it's gonna be fantastic! Alright, so what you're gonna need for this dish, you're gonna need some white kidney beans, then you're gonna need some pancetta, some fresh basil, some parmigiano reggiano for topping, some garlic, one red onion, some shortcut pasta of your choice. Today we're using tubettis, and three stalks of celery, along with some passata sauce, salt and pepper, and a delicious baguette to eat. Capasta fagiola che ti fa a così. All right, so let's get cooking. First things first, what we're going to do is we're going to take a pot, bring our pot to the cutting board, and we're going to put in this pot a little bit of olive oil in there, not too much. And I'm going to show you guys how we cut and prep our pancetta for this dish. Pancetta is very important for this dish. I'll explain why. Because pancetta has so much flavor. The fat in the pork is going to give a velvet taste to our pasta fagioli, as well as the salt in the pancetta. So, pancetta for pasta fagioli, traditional, very, very important. All right? So, we're going to put our pot aside for the moment. We're going to take our pancetta, and I'll show you guys just how we prep it. Alright guys, so first things first, what we're going to do is we're going to cut our pancetta. I'll show you just how to do that. Make sure you have a nice sharp knife, something beautiful, something good, something heavy, something expensive. No, I'm joking. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to take our pancetta and we're going to cut our pancetta lengthwise. Alright, so very simply lengthwise like that. And then you're going to lie down your pancetta and just go ahead and give little shards right through that pancetta. So you're going to keep going like this until all your pancetta is all cut the same way. All right? Perfect. Then we're going to chop one onion. Set this aside. We're going to chop one onion and a few cloves of garlic. About 2 cloves of garlic should be good for this dish. Let's put that aside. Chop it through. And you want to get that pancetta nice and gold because the golder the pancetta is, the more tastes it releases. So you want to go ahead and get that pancetta really nice and cubed out and golden brown so it releases all those flavors. I want to thank, guys, all my sponsors while we're here. I want to thank Charcuterie Noel for sponsoring us. I want to thank Friends for Cause, as well as Europa Coffee, as well as Zina Coiffure and my boy Frank for the beautiful clothes. Thank you, Frank. Swag shop. All right, so thank you very much. As well as Guzzi Productions. Thanks to my buddy Frank for giving me this occasion and this opportunity. I really, really feel blessed because of him. And thanks to all of you for watching and not dying after my recipes. Keeps me practicing and trying to get you dead. I'm joking. All right, good. So let's just push that pancetta aside. Actually, what you could do is you could take that pancetta and put it straight into the pot. We're going to cut the end of the celery and the tips. And then we're just going to rinse that celery. Nice. Now what you want to do is you want to slid your celery right down the middle so you get some uniform, again, slices and dices. So you're going to grab your knife, place your knife right into the center of the celery, and just line it through. Very simple. You're going to repeat the process for all your celery. Celery is not a must in this dish, but I find that celery gives so much taste to this dish, so that's why I add it to the dish. Simple. I'm going to take off the bigger ends of the celery. Just gonna put that aside just because I wanna make it all even. And I'm just gonna chop it through. Everybody could cook this at home and everybody can make it. It's very simple, nothing complicated, okay guys? So, if you're not a chef, after my episodes, you will be a chef! All right, good. Let's get cracking. We're gonna push that celery aside. We're gonna go ahead and grab our garlic. You're gonna slice that butt and just smash it down. Once you smash it, you just wiggle that stuff off, and there you go, you have a clean garlic. Fantastic, very easy, nothing complicated. You don't have to go crazy. You know, like back in the day, they used to take a little knife and they used to scrape that skin off. All right. So very simple. You're just going to run your knife through the butt and then slap. And when you see your garlic is done, you're just going to pull that skin right off. And that's it. Very simple. Nothing complicated. Perfect. I'm just going to roughly chop that garlic. So more or less, it's the size of the celery. Then you're going to go grab your onion, cut it in half. Take off the butt. Oop, and the head. I don't know what I did there, but and the head. And that peel should come right off. So you're just going to grab it there and just... That's it. We're going to rinse and just take off the membrane of the onion because you don't want to eat the membrane of the onion. It's like your wife telling you to clean the house when you don't want to clean it. All right? So trust me, you don't want that. All right? You're going to lift your half of your onion. You're going to cut through but not all the way through. Then you're going to lie it down. You're going to make little strands like this. And then you're just going to chop it and you should have a perfectly diced onion. Et voila. Done. Nothing complicated, once again. Okay? So now we're going to go to the oven top. All right, so first things first, guys, what we're going to do is we're going to cook that pancetta. We're going to get a nice color on the pancetta. So as you can see in here, I only have pancetta. I added a bit of oil just to speed up the process, but we don't want too much oil because the pancetta gives out already a beautiful taste of oil and fragrance that you don't need to add oil to this dish. So we're just going to cook that through and get a nice crispy color. Once that's cooked, what's going to happen is we're going to set that aside and we're going to start making our broth, and we're going to add it to our broth once our broth is done. Now lower that a bit. So we're having our fire at about a medium high heat just to get that nice and going and caramelized. That's what we want to do. Okay, so once that's going to be cooked, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to come here to our cutting board and we're going to grab all our vegetables. We got our celery, we got our garlic, and we got our onion, and we're going to go ahead and throw that with the pig fat into that pot, and it's going to caramelize as well. It's going to loosen up, it's going to become translucent, and those flavors are going to open and it's going to taste beautifully. And then you guys are going to want another show, but I'm not going to give it to you because I'm busy eating pasta fagioli. So as you can see, we're getting our color here. More or less, when it pinks like this, what you want to do is you want to just give it another few minutes, and it should, after this point, start crisping up very, very fast. Nice crisp is already around. We don't want to overcook it. This right here should be perfect cooked. Not too crispy and not too underdone. That is perfect. So you want to take that aside and put that in a bowl. Just the pancetta. At this point, once your pancetta is out, you're gonna lower your fire to a medium low. That's it, all right? So, in the same pot that we are working with, what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab our onions, all our veggies, and we're gonna go ahead and throw them into that pot. But when you throw them into that pot, you're gonna take it off the fire because you don't want to shock your vegetables. If you shock your vegetables, what's going to happen is they're going to burn and they're not going to release the flavors they're supposed to release. All right, so we're going to go ahead and throw that into the pot. Perfect. We're going to cook those vegetables through. Just move your pot around like this. What you can do is you can take it just to mix it like this. so that when you mix your vegetables, at the same time, it's going to deglaze the bottom. And as you can see, you see, the bottom is deglazed. So all those flavors are into your veggies. Hey, mamma non resa non fuori, che cazzo. All right. Allora, once that's done and it's translucent, you're going to go ahead and grab your white kidney beans. I have two kinds here. I have the whiter ones and I got the yellow ones. So this is perfect. It gives much more aroma and taste to your pasta fagioli. So you're going to go ahead and dump that in. Mix that all together. And this is what you should have. So at this point, you're going to let that cook and you're going to open up. When you see that you smell that onion and that celery, because you are going to smell it, and you're going to smell an intense smell of garlic and onion, you're doing a good job. That's when we're going to go ahead and add half a pot of water to this. All right? We're going to cook that for about 3 minutes, not more. You don't want to overcook them, especially if you're using canned beans. If you overcook them, they'll turn to mush and you have no texture in your pasta fagioli. So keep that in mind when you're cooking. To this, we're going to add a pinch of salt. Not too much because we have the pancetta. I'm going to stir it up again. And then I'm going to grab some black pepper. Whatever black pepper you have. So we're going to add some black pepper to this. Oh, cameraman, don't laugh. All right. That's it. And then you slap it like you slap the balls. Acuse, and that's it. Then you mix everything together. Perfect. Now, some people add, at this point, they'll add tomato paste. I don't add tomato paste because it renders all your vegetables that have sweetened up, sour, and acidy. So I don't add it. Don't really need it. So it's up to you guys if you want to add it. If you don't want to add it, I suggest you don't add it. As for the pasta, when the broth is done, the pasta is always cooked separate. Why do we cook it separate? Well, for the simple reason that if you want to eat wet toilet paper in pasta fagiolo, dove su cazzidoi. But però, me, I like texture in my food. So I'm going to cook it apart and just put a bit of pasta, two-thirds pasta and one-third, two-thirds pasta and one part broth. Okay? So keep that in mind. Perfect. So right now, as you can see, everything has sweated beautifully. Everything is nicely married. So I'm going to go ahead and add some water to this dish. It's about halfway. You don't want to put too much water because, again, if you put too much water, you're diluting the flavors. So halfway, reduced, it's going to be fantastic. Back onto the stovetop. At this point, you're going to add another few pinches of salt. I'd say about a good tablespoon of salt. And then a touch of black pepper. Black pepper. We're going to go back to the chopping board at this point while this is coming to a boil. So we're going to bring it to a boil. And we're going to chop some beautiful and fresh basilico. So we're going to take this basilico and you're going to remove the thicker strands and just remove that you have a beautiful and fantastic green leaf, okay? Do not use the flower of your basil because the flower is horrible. Disgusting. That's it, garbage. All right? So you take all those leaves, but leave the top of your basil out of this recipe. You are not welcome. We're going to take some basil leaves. We're going to start chopping some. We're going to keep some for the end of the recipe, okay? Very important. You don't want to cook all your recipes. So you're going to grab your big leaves and put them one into each other like this. All right? The bigger ones are the best. And then you're going to roll it like a cigar, like so. Grab your knife. Sorry, cameraman. You're going to grab your knife, and you're just going to chop it like that. So when you roll it, it's going to give you the perfect strands. Look at that. And it's going to go just everywhere into your broth. That is simply beautiful and aromatic. Gonna go ahead and throw that basil in, and we're gonna grab our passata and we're gonna put half of the bottle of passata in. Perfect. We're going to bring that to a boil, maximum heat, and we're going to just wait until it boils. You're going to boil this for about 5 minutes. Once the 5 minutes is up, you're going to take a beautiful cover like this or whatever shield you have for Halloween, and you can grab this, you're going to lid it, and you're going to simmer it for about 45 minutes. So bring this to a boil. Once it's at a boil, we're going to cook it for 45 minutes on simmer. We'll be back in a jiff. All right, guys, it's been about 45 minutes. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to close the fire, seeing that it's been, and I'm going to let it naturally calm down. So I'm not going to take it off of the fire because I want all those ingredients to still marry each other, okay? So I want it to self and alone calm down on its own, if that makes sense. No, hold on, that doesn't make sense. Okay, doesn't matter. You understood. All right, good. So the water's boiling. What we're going to do is we're going to put our pasta into the water and get it cooking. We're going to put about, for three people, usually you put like about a cup and a half of pasta. You don't really put more than that because you don't want to put too much pasta, okay? So about a cup and a half of pasta is more than enough. All right. You're going to move that around just once so it doesn't stick. Just until you feel that it's all loosened up. Bring up your pasta. Just shake it like that. And that should be good to go. Perfect. You want your pasta to be al dente in any situation. I'll explain how you know your pasta is al dente. Guys, do not take your pasta and throw it on the wall. And then it comes down and you see a little S sign that you can never get out. Don't do that. We're not in 1950. Take your pasta out of the dish. And just bite. And if you see that the center of the pasta is still white, when it's barely white, it's al dente. So when you can hardly see the white, it's al dente. It's done. Ready to go. All right? So about 8 minutes, don't read your pack of pasta because about 8 minutes of pasta is perfectly al dente. Okay? All right. Let's go. So we're going to keep turning that for the first, I'd say 6 minutes. You'd be turning every minute and a half because small pasta tends to stick together. So just move that around and make sure that it doesn't stick together to the bottom of that dish. Another trick that you can do instead of turning, when you drop in your pasta, you just turn your pot like this and it's going to prevent from it to stick to the bottom. Okay? So our pasta, our broth is done. This is the result that we have.
Madonna, guys, if you could smell this.
Ooh, Betty! Oh, yeah! Beautiful. So I'm going to move that around just to show you guys how it looks when it's done. And you could see the beautiful flavors in there. Like, look how beautiful and thickened that is. Just look at that. Simply amazing. Okay? So this is where you want your pasta fagioli to be. Not too thick and not too liquidy. All right? So that's done. Once that's done, we're going to take our bacon. Drop our bacon. Or pancetta, it was pancetta. And we're going to just stir that together. And now our pancetta has disappeared. Pancetta! I don't know where it is. Okay, it doesn't matter because it ended up here, so I don't care. All right, good. So what we're going to do is we're going to take fresh basil, the rest of our basil that we had, put it on a cutting board, and you're going to roll the rest of that all together. Remember, guys, if you see a head, remove it. You don't want that. All right? And you're just going to give it a rough chop. So one and two. So you have three more or less big pieces of basil. If you see any brown spots, remove them. They're not good to eat. That's your basil ready to go in. So we're going to go to our pasta. We're going to stir it another time just to make sure it doesn't stick. We're going to check that pasta. It's perfect, and it didn't stick. Perfect, so I know what I'm doing. And I'll show you guys what I do. I just grab one piece of pasta. I pop it in the mouth. I got it, and it's still hard. When it's slightly not hard, your pasta is done. You're going to take that pasta, and you're going to drain it immediately. Very important. So I'm just going to move that pasta around one more time. This should be done in about another 5 minutes. It's 3 minutes it's in there. So another 5 minutes should be cooked. Okay? Meanwhile, what we're going to do is we're going to take our broth. We're going to go to the top. Oh, look at that beautiful broth, guys. Isn't that fantastic. Alright, so another 3 minutes we should have, another 4 minutes we should have for that to cook. You're gonna take your basil and just drop it in there. Just drop it in to your broth, but don't mix it. Let the broth pull that basil down. Another 2 minutes, it should be done. That's it, took me about a minute to be stupid. Probably another minute to realize it, and I just realized it. I'm joking. Okay. So it's almost done. We're going to close our fire right before it's al dente. And then once again, you're going to let that calm down on its own. And it should give you the perfect texture to your pasta. It's phenomenal. You need to have pasta al dente. Because if you don't have pasta al dente, then you have pagati, fragili, capito? Hello. It's getting there. It's getting there. Yes, sir. Hey, guys, the aroma of this. Look at that beautiful broth. Pasta fagioli autenticamente italiana. Ecco. So we're going to go ahead, grab our dishes, spread them out, grab our pasta. And don't worry if there's a bit of water in it, okay? So with a straining spoon, you're going to go ahead and place the pasta in a bowl. Grab our broth. And as you can see, that's the perfect amount of pasta, okay? So a cup and a half is perfect for three people, okay? It gives you even portion, and it's more than enough. Nobody eats more than the other person, okay? Goes out. Now to the best part, ladies and gentlemen, of this fantastic cooking show. The best! Cooking show you'll never see. And if you watch another cooking show, I'm gonna put you in the statistica. Did you? Porco Dio. Thanks for watching. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and just move those flavors around. Look at that beautiful pancetta just sitting there. Oh my god, look at that. Oh, so we're just gonna move that around, grab our pasta, and throw it. Perfect. And there you go, ladies and gentlemen, a delicious, fantastic tasting pasta e fagioli. With that said, we're going to come back in a few minutes and I'll show you how you can make, because Italians, what do we do after eating? Oh, fanno espresso! I'm going to show you how to make a delicious coffee with some fantastic desserts that are offered to us from Europa Café. And by the way, I want to say for this beautiful dish, thank you, Charcuterie Noel. I really appreciate the gesture. Thank you to all my sponsors, Friends for Life, Europa Café, Frank Guzzi Productions, Zina Café, Zina Coiffure, Frank Yem for the nice treads. Like, honestly, Frank, honestly, I feel like I could fart through this and it's going to be amazing. This is perfect for pasta fagioli, my friend. Perfect. So thanks to all our sponsors. Stay tuned. We're going to show you a mean dessert after this. Te gris. Oof, mamma mia, guys. That dish was amazing. What was best after eating to digest? A delicious coffee. And this coffee is brought to you in part by Europa Café. You guys really need to try this out. Not only do they have coffee, but they have delicious homemade tiramisu that you can bring home and taste just the Italy in it. So with that said, enjoy yourself a good coffee after a good supper. And thanks for watching Devil's Fork. I am Chef Taddeo. Ciao, guys.